Okay, so here's our mass, hanging from the ceiling on a spring with a spring constant k. If I started shaking up and down, oscillating, we know it will move with a certain period. How do we adjust that period? Well, let me first tell you the force law of a spring. And to do this, it actually might be better to think of this spring being horizontal. So here's our spring at its normal happy equilibrium position. We're going to call the equilibrium position x equals 0. Now let's see, when we stretch this spring a bit, when we move the mass back to, let's say, here, to some position x, well, the spring exerts a force backwards, back towards the equilibrium. So the force of a spring is somehow negative. If I pull to the right, it pulls to the left. And in fact, if I pull further to the right, it pulls harder to the left. If you've ever pulled on a spring, you can tell pulling it a little bit is easy, pulling it more is more difficult. So actually, the force is proportional to how much you stretch it. And what's the constant of proportionality? Well, that's why we have this letter K. So this is the force on a spring, and we know from our good buddy Newton that forces cause accelerations. In this case, the spring will accelerate this way due to this spring force. So why don't we replace this F with this minus KX? Well, in that case, we get MA equals minus KX, and so A equals negative K over M times X. Now, I hope you followed along so far. The acceleration is equal to minus K over M times X. The reason why I say I hope you followed along is because, unfortunately, now I have to do something that I hate to do. I have to just tell you something. And that something is that whenever you can write a force law like this, that the acceleration is equal to minus something times x times its displacement from its equilibrium, well, it turns out that this something is always equal to omega squared. And remember, omega is our radians per second, our angular frequency. Now, let's say you have a spring, spring constant 50 newtons per meter. And let's say you want your period to be equal to 1 second. Remember, period is equal to 2 pi over omega. And why do we want 1 second? Well, we're trying to design a clock here. Of course we want a 1 second period. We want tick, tock, tick, tock. So the question is, with this spring and this desired period, what mass do we need? Enter your answer here in kilograms.